Hello everyone, in today's class we are going to discuss about clamping circuits. Clamping circuits are the circuits which are being used to add DC level as per requirement in the output of the AC signal. Okay, so whenever we want to add some DC quantity to the AC input signal, then we will be using these clamping circuits. Okay. This clamper circuit is sometimes called as DC restorer or DC inserter. Okay, so as we are adding some DC to the AC input signal, sometimes this clamper circuit is called as DC inserter also. Okay, and there are two types of clamping circuits. One is positive clamper, another is negative clamper. Okay, let us consider a positive clamper. Okay, so as of now we are not considering how does the circuit diagram of a positive clamper is going to look like. Just we are considering it as a black box, so that we will be considering an input signal which is a sinusoidal input signal that is shown here for one particular cycle, whose peak value is Vm and negative peak value is minus Vm. Okay, so that the peak to peak value is 2 Vm. Okay. When we try to observe the output waveform of this positive clamper, when this kind of input signal is passed through a positive clamper, then you will be observing the output as shown here. Okay, so what is your observation is, my output is given as the input voltage plus Vm, where Vm is the peak value of the input signal. Okay, for example, my input voltage at t is equal to 0 is 0, and when I add my input 0 to the voltage Vm, I will be getting an output Vm. That is why at t is equal to 0 in the output signal, my output is found to be Vm. At t is equal to, at this instant of time, my input signal is Vm. So when I substitute my input as Vm, Vm plus Vm is 2 Vm. So at this instant, let us say at t by 4, okay, at this instant, let us say at t by 4, right, my output is found to be 2 Vm, because I am adding Vm to my input signal that is present at t is equal to t by 4, so that my output at t is equal to t by 4 is 2 Vm, okay. So my output of the positive clamper circuit is being given by simply adding this Vm to my input signal, okay. So one more important observation here is that the peak to peak of my input signal is same as my peak to peak of the output signal. Okay, so when we observe your shape of the output signal compared to your input signal, the shape of the signal is not getting varied. Okay, so the shape is going to remain constant, unlike your earlier clipper circuits, where your portion of the input signal is being clipped off either above the reference level or below the reference level, or in between two reference levels. Your peak to peak of the output signal is no more equivalent to your peak to peak of the input signal. But in the case of a clamping circuit, the peak to peak of the input signal is same as the peak to peak of the output signal. So one important observation. Okay, so the output of the positive clamper circuit is given as a Vi plus Vm. Okay, where Vm is some peak value of the input signal. Okay. Now let us consider a negative clamper circuit. Okay, so again let us consider a black box for your negative clamper circuit, so that the similar kind of input signal is being applied even to this kind of clamper circuit also. Let us see how does the output waveform is going to look like. So when you observe your output waveform, it is being shown like this. Okay, so that you can understand that your output is given by Vi minus Vm. Earlier, in the case of positive clamper circuit, your output is given by Vi plus Vm. In the case of negative clamper circuit, your output is given by Vi minus Vm. Okay, Vi minus Vm, right? Okay, so just to have a look at your output when compared to your input. So when your input is 0 at t is equal to 0, when you substitute your input as 0, my output has to be minus Vm at t is equal to 0. So at t is equal to 0, my output is minus Vm. At t is equal to t by 4, at this instant, my input is Vm. So when I replace my input with Vm, Vm minus Vm is 0. So at t is equal to t by 4, my output is 0. Okay, so your output is simply given by Vi minus Vm, where Vm is something like your positive peak of your input sinusoidal signal. Okay, right? Let us consider this positive clamper circuit. So this is the circuit diagram of your positive clamper circuit, and this is the input-output relationship of your positive clamper circuit. So my output of a positive clamper is given by to the input, which is an AC signal, you are adding some DC quantity. Okay, so some DC level you are adding to your AC input signal in order to get an output of your clamper circuit. Okay, before we start analyzing this particular circuit, analysis means finding the output voltage for the entire input range. Okay, this input can be either sinusoidal waveform or a square waveform. Okay, so for the entire input range, okay, you need to find out how does your output is going to vary, right? That is what is analysis, right? So we will be analyzing this circuit considering three cases. Case number one is ideal diode, assuming that your diode is ideal. Okay, assuming that your diode is ideal. So you all know that, okay, how does your ideal diode is going to behave. Okay, for example, if you consider your diode, okay, if you consider your diode, if you apply a voltage Vf across your diode such that your diode is being forward biased, p side is made more in potential than the n side, so it is said to be operated in the forward bias, then some current that is flowing from p side to the n side, okay, from p side to the n side is given by If. Okay, and the ideal characteristics are being shown like this. Okay, the ideal characteristics, voltage versus current, okay, of an ideal diode, they look like this. Okay, this is my voltage V, this is my current I through the diode. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? 0 volts is enough for your diode, okay, to conduct some current. In particular, it is infinite amount of current. Okay, so when I try to find my RF offered by my diode, RF is given by Vf by voltage applied across the diode by current through the diode. Okay, current is not zero. Okay, current is not zero, it can be any finite number, but Vf is zero. For 0 volts itself your diode is conducting, so this Vf is going to be zero. That means your RF is nothing but 0. Okay, how do I represent RF as 0 ohms? Nothing but your diode has to be represented with short circuit. Okay, so that is why you are representing your diode whenever it is being forward biased. Okay, whenever it is being forward biased, you are representing with a short circuit. Okay, whenever you made your diode forward biased, you are representing with a short circuit. Okay, short circuit means making your RF 0. Okay, all right. Okay, similarly, if you make your diode reverse biased, okay, similarly, if you make your diode reverse biased, then what happens? I'll be applying some reverse voltage such that my P side is less in potential than the N side. Okay, so that current is flowing not from P side to the N side, but from N side to the P side. Okay, this time let it be denoted with IR. Okay, and if I try to find out my reverse resistance, okay, if I try to find out my reverse resistance, then it is given by VR by IR. Okay, right, VR by IR. But you know that the current that is flowing when your voltage applied across the diode is negative, okay, when your diode is being operated in the reverse bias, the current is zero. So that means this time the current is zero. Okay, this time the current is zero, but not the voltage. Okay, voltage is finite, but current is being zero. Okay, my voltage is somewhere here. Voltage is not zero, but current is zero. So finite value by, in the denominator, if it is zero, it is equivalent to infinity. Okay, so how do I represent my resistance is infinity? Whenever my diode is being said to be operated in the reverse bias, okay, then I'll be replacing my diode with an open circuit. representing my resistance offered by the diode, which is infinity, is nothing but open circuit. Okay, so this is nothing but your open circuit. Okay, so when your diode is being operated in the reverse bias, you are representing your diode with an open circuit because the resistance offered by your diode is almost infinity. Okay, so that is what we are going to consider as the first case. So in the first case, we are saying that diode is ideal. Whenever the diode is ideal, the resistance offered by the diode in the forward bias region is zero. The resistance offered by the diode in the reverse bias region is infinity. Okay, right. So in the second case, what we will be considering is, I'll be representing my diode. Okay, I'll be representing my diode with a resistance denoted by R suffix small f when it is forward biased. Okay, whenever my diode is being operated in the forward biased. Okay, in the second case, I'll be replacing my diode with its equivalent resistance, that is forward biased resistance, of course, which is small in magnitude. Okay, so whenever my diode is being operated in the forward bias region, ideally it has to be zero. We'll be replacing normally with short circuit, but we'll assume that some finite value, and that is being denoted with RF. If it is being operated in the reverse bias, okay, whenever my diode is being operated in the reverse bias, okay, then I'll replace that with a resistance, okay, denoted by RR, okay, which is offered by your diode. Okay, ideally this RR is infinity, that is why I am replacing this with open circuit. Ideally this RF is zero, that is why I am replacing my diode with a short circuit. Okay, so instead of replacing with short circuit, if I replace with an RF, okay, that means my diode is not conducting for zero voltage itself. Okay, here I will be not replacing with an open circuit, instead I will be replacing with a resistance which is very larger in magnitude. Okay, so that means we are slowly coming out of the ideality. Okay, ideally they are short circuited and open circuited. Now when I consider some value for my RF and RR, depending upon my diode is forward biased or reverse biased, that means I am getting into the more practical aspects of the diode. Okay, so this is what we consider in the second case. Okay, in the case one, we'll assume the diode is ideal. Okay, blindly we'll replace the diode with short circuit if it is forward biased, open circuit if it is reverse bias. In the second case, we will be replacing our diode with RF if it is forward biased, RR if it is reverse biased. Okay, right. So in the third case, we'll include V gamma. What is V gamma? You know that V gamma is the minimum amount of voltage that you need to apply across your diode for the diode to conduct. Okay, we'll say that diode drop. Okay, forward bias voltage drop across the diode. V gamma it is, for silicon it is roughly 0.7 volts and for germanium it is approximately 0.3 volts. Okay, so we will be including this particular value of the given diode in the third case. Okay, so in the case one, we'll assume that diode is ideal. In case two, we'll assume that diode is being replaced with some finite value of its equivalent resistance being operated in the forward bias, represented with small capital R suffix small f. If it is operated in the reverse bias, you represent with capital R suffix small r. In the third case, we'll try to look at the effect of including the diode drop also. Okay, including the diode drop also. Okay, so these are the three cases, okay, in which we will be analyzing this particular circuit. Okay, right. Okay,
okay. Analysis of positive clamper circuit using ideal diode model. Okay, let us consider the positive clamper circuit. Here is the positive clamper circuit where you are taking your output voltage across the diode in such a way that to the N side of the diode you are connecting the plus terminal of the output voltage, and to the P side of the diode you are connecting minus terminal of the output voltage. Okay, so when you are taking your output voltage across the diode, when it is placed in this position, you are calling it as a positive clamper circuit. Okay, so now we are interested in analyzing this positive clamper circuit when the diode is said to be an ideal diode. Okay, and the input that is being applied to this circuit is a sinusoidal input signal, okay, which is varying as shown here. We assumed that it is starting at t is equal to 0. Okay. Initially, let us assume that the capacitor is uncharged. Okay. So initially the voltage across the capacitor is 0. So that means the capacitor is uncharged before the input is getting applied. Okay. So with this assumption that my voltage across the capacitor is 0, whatever the input voltage I apply, that will be applied directly across the diode. Okay. So because my voltage across the capacitor is 0, my input voltage is appearing across the diode. Okay. Now over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is reverse biased, and as we are considering the ideal diode model, diode is being replaced with open circuit. Okay. And why do my diode is reverse biased in this region? Over the interval 0 to T by 4, my input is positive, and that positive input is being appearing across the diode, which is placed in a position like N to P. So whenever a positive voltage is applied to the N side of my diode is said to be reverse biased. So that is why over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is said to be reverse biased, and thereby it has been replaced with an open circuit. Okay. When I try to find the time constant of the circuit, the time constant is given by RTH times C. Okay. You all know the time constant is RC. Okay. Where RTH is the equivalent resistance. So in this case, the equivalent resistance is RL itself, where RL may be the load resistance of the circuit. Okay. So in general, for proper operation of the clamping circuit, we will be choosing this RL to be very large. Okay. So that the RLC, which is the time constant, is going to be much greater than capital T, which is the time period of the input signal. Okay. So you could see that capital T is the time period of the input signal. So by choosing this RL very large, we are making the time constant RLC to be much greater than capital T. So when we make this time constant much greater than capital T, the capacitor is not able to charge, though there is a path for the capacitor to charge upon applying some input voltage. Because the time constant is very large, the capacitor is not able to charge. Okay. So that what is my voltage across the capacitor, by the time I reach this time capital T by 4, 0 volts only, because capacitor is not able to charge, as my diode is not conducting, as well as my charging time constant is very, very large compared to the capital T. So this RLC is much greater than capital T is the requirement for the proper operation of the clamping circuit. Okay. Right. So over this same interval 0 to T by 4, okay, my output is same as the input. Why do my output is same as the input? Because my voltage across the capacitor is 0, my output is same as the input. Okay. So let me draw the output waveform over this interval 0 to T by 4. Right. So now let us consider the next interval, that is T by 4 to capital T by 2. Okay. Over this interval, right, my voltage across the capacitor is 0 volts. Okay. With this voltage across the capacitor is 0 volts. Again, whatever the input voltage I apply, it will be applied across the diode. Okay. And over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, my input is still positive. So when a positive voltage is applied to the N side of my diode, then it is going to be reverse biased. Okay. So when my diode is reverse biased, I'll be replacing my diode with an open circuit. Okay. And when I try to find my time constant, it is given by RLC. And as I will be choosing my RLC as much greater than capital T, my voltage across the capacitor is still zero. So that means when I try to find my voltage across the capacitor at t is equal to capital T by 2, then it is almost zero, because the time that is provided for the capacitor to recharge is almost very large. Okay, so that is why the capacitor is not able to charge. So its voltage across it is almost zero. Okay. And over this interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, my output is same as input, because as long as my capacitor is zero, my output is same as the input. So the clamping operation comes into the picture, okay, only when the capacitor is going to start charging. When will the capacitor is going to start charging? Only when the diode is going to start conducting. Okay, so that is, whenever my diode is being operated in the forward bias, then it conducts. And only when the diode is conducting, then only the capacitor starts charging. Only when the capacitor is charging, then only the clamping operation comes into the picture. So as long as voltage across the capacitor is zero, my output voltage is same as the input voltage. Okay, so let me draw the output voltage, which is same as the input voltage, right? Let us consider the next interval, that is capital T by 2 to 3 T by 4. Okay. Over this interval, okay, my voltage across the capacitor is still zero. Okay. So even after my capital T by 2, my voltage across the capacitor is zero. So with my voltage across the capacitor, again my entire input voltage is going to appear across the diode. But this time, over the interval T by 2 to 3 T by 4, my input is negative, which is going to make my diode forward biased. Okay. So when my diode is forward biased, I'll be replacing my diode with a short circuit, and there results some current that is flowing through the diode, always from P side to the N side. And I have chosen my voltage across the capacitor to be with the polarities as shown here, which is in alignment with the current flowing through the diode, that is from P side to the N side. Okay. So for the capacitor to charge, the current has to flow through the capacitor. And as my diode is being in the on state, or it is being in the forward biased case, current flows through the diode from P side to the N side, and thereby the capacitor starts charging. Okay. When we look at the time constant, my time constant is given by RThC, where RTH is found to be 0, so my time constant is 0. So as my time constant for the charging, okay, so as the time charging time constant is 0, my capacitor is going to charge very quickly to the value that is applied as the input. So what is my voltage across the capacitor is going to be? My voltage across the capacitor is going to be minus Vi. So when I simply apply the KVL around this loop, I'll be getting my Vc is equal to minus Vi. Right? So then what is my voltage across the capacitor at the time t is equal to 3t by 4? At the time t is equal to 3t by 4, my voltage across the capacitor is minus Vi. At that time, 3t by 4, my input is minus Vm. So minus of minus is plus. So my voltage across the capacitor is plus Vm at 3t by 4. When my voltage across the capacitor at 3t by 4 minus is plus Vm, and at 3t by 4 plus is also going to be plus Vm. Okay. In the same interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, my output voltage is going to be 0, because my diode is conducting. As my diode is conducting, my voltage across the diode is 0, because it is an ideal diode. So let me draw my output voltage over this interval, which is nothing but 0. Okay. Right. Now let us consider the another interval, that is 3T by 4 to capital T. Over the interval 3t by 4 to capital T, now my voltage across the capacitor is no more 0, it is plus Vm. Okay, so immediately after 3t by 4, my voltage across the capacitor is plus Vm. Okay, so if we want to know whether my diode is in the forward biased region or in the reverse biased region, we have to consider the voltage across the diode. Okay. So I am considering my voltage across the diode with the polarity shown like this. Okay, plus to the N side of the diode and minus to the P side of the diode. with this polarity that is being chosen, whenever my VD is positive, my diode is said to be in the reverse biased region. Whenever my VD is negative, my diode is said to be in the forward biased region. Okay, so we need to understand how does this VD is being given by and on what value of input voltage this VD is going to become either positive or negative. Thereby, I'll be able to say whether my diode is forward biased or reverse biased. Okay. So let me write my V naught is equal to VD is equal to with the polarity what I have considered. Okay. So I have considered my VD with the polarity what I have shown here, which I can write it as VC plus VI. Okay. So VD, voltage across the diode with the polarity what I have shown, I can write it as VC plus VI. But what is VC? VC is we found out to be VM, okay, over the interval what we have considered. So with VD is equal to VM plus VI, okay, what is my diode is going to be in which state? Okay, for my diode to be in the forward bias region, VD has to be negative, and when VD is positive, diode is said to be in the reverse bias region. Okay, for example, let us take VM is equal to 10 volts. Okay, with VM is equal to 10 volts, what is my VI can be over this interval 3T by 4 to capital T? What is my input is at 3T by 4 it is minus VM. When I am exceeding this 3T by 4, okay, my input can be minus 9.9, minus 9.8, minus 9.7, and so on. So when I substitute like minus 9.9, my VD is positive. Minus 9.8, my VD is positive. So for all my input, okay, my VD is going to be positive. When my VD is positive, my diode is said to be in the reverse bias region. Okay, suppose if I want my diode to be in the forward bias region, then my VD has to be negative. For what value of VI, my VD can be negative. For my VD to be negative, my VI has to be minus 10.1, minus 10.2, and so on. So that means my VI has to be beyond minus 10. Can my VI can go beyond minus 10? At max, it can go up to minus 10, but not minus 10.1 or minus 10.2. So until and otherwise, your VI can go beyond minus 10, your VD can never be negative. As long as your VD is not negative, as long as your VD is positive, your diode is said to be in the reverse bias region. Okay. So as there is no possibility for your VI to go beyond minus 10 volts, your diode can never be in the on state from this interval onwards. Not only from 3T by 4 to capital T, it can be extended up to infinity. Okay. So that is from 3T by 4 to infinity, my diode is no more going to be in the on state, it is going to be in the off state only, right? So with my diode is in the reverse biased, I replaced my diode with an open circuit, okay? And the time constant when I find it is found to be RLC. As RLC is very large, you know that always I'll be choosing that condition RLC is much greater than capital T, the time period of input signal is satisfied, so that the capacitor is not able to discharge through the path that is available, which is RL. Okay, so as the capacitor is not able to discharge, as the discharging time constant is very very large compared to the capital T, my capacitor is able to hold the value that it has got accumulated during the earlier cycles. Okay, so now the capacitor is holding the value which is nothing but VM, okay, instead of discharging through the RL. Okay, so why it is not able to discharge through the RL? Because your discharging time constant is very large compared to capital. So assuming that my capacitor is now holding the value that is VM, my output voltage is now given as VM plus VI. Okay, so my output voltage is now given as VM plus VI. Okay, so when I use this equation, my output is equal to VI plus VM, then I'll be able to get my output voltage, okay, so which is looking like this. Okay, so this is what is my output voltage is, how it is going to look like over the interval 0 to capital T by 2. Okay, my output is same as the input. Over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, as my diode is conducting, that is in the on state, okay, my output voltage is going to be 0. Though my output voltage is 0 because my diode is conducting, but my capacitor is going to start charging. Okay, by the time it is going to end up this 3T by 4 time, okay, it is going to accumulate a voltage, that is Vm. So beyond this 3T by 4, okay, my diode is no more going to be in the on state, it is going to be in the off state. When once the diode is in the off state, as my capacitor cannot be able to discharge through the RL, capacitor is going to hold that value Vm, so that my output voltage is being given by Vi plus Vm. Okay. For example, at this time instant, my Vi is Vm, so that my output is 2 Vm. Okay. At this time instant, my Vi is minus Vm, so that my output is going to be 0. Why 0? Because when I substitute my Vi is equal to minus Vm, my output is going to be 0. Okay. So likewise, my output is following V0 is equal to Vi plus Vm. Okay. So there is one more important observation that we can make here is, okay, either your output is following an equation like Vi plus Vm, as it is a positive clamper circuit, or you could see that your negative peak is clamped to the 0 volts. Okay, your negative peak is clamped to the 0 volts. Right? Okay, so in all the cases, okay, if you consider a positive clamper circuit, your negative peak is going to be clamped to the 0 if it is an ideal positive clamper circuit. Okay, right? Okay. Let us solve one problem. Let us consider the positive clamper circuit to which this kind of input signal is applied. Okay, so the input signal is a square waveform whose peak value is plus 5 volts and negative peak is minus 5 volts. So, with the assumption that my voltage across the capacitor is 0 initially, so when I apply this positive half cycle, that is plus 5 volts, it will be appearing directly across the diode, so which makes the diode off. So with the voltage across the capacitor 0 volts, diode is getting off and my output voltage is given as same as the input voltage. As I told earlier, whenever my voltage across the capacitor is 0, my output is going to be same as the input. So my output is same as the input. So when I apply the negative half cycle, okay, where my input is going to be negative, which will be making my diode on. Okay. So when my diode is being on, my capacitor is going to start charging. Okay, and the current direction is shown from P side to the N side, and the voltage across the capacitor is shown with the polarities in accordance with the current direction of the diode. Okay, so the capacitor is now going to start charging to reach towards the input value. Okay, so when I draw the output voltage is 0 as my diode is going to be in the on state, which is being replaced with a short circuit, that is my output voltage is 0. Okay, right? So by the time my capacitor is charging, okay, it is going to accumulate a voltage which is 5 volts. Okay, so what is the voltage that will be accumulated by the capacitor over one cycle is 5 volts. Okay, now when I apply this 5 volts, okay, to my input, with my plus 5 volts accumulated at the capacitor and plus 5 volts applied at the input, my voltage across the diode is now going to be plus 10 volts. As plus 10 volts across the diode is going to make the diode switch off, okay. So now, when the diode is made switched off or in the, operated in the reverse bias, okay, so the capacitor is not able to discharge through the path that is provided here with the help of this RL, as the discharging time constant is very large, intentionally you are ensuring that the RLC is much greater than capital T, so that my capacitor is not going to discharge, instead it is going to hold that value across it, which is nothing but 5 volts. Okay, so that my output is now being given by voltage across the capacitor plus the input voltage. Here the voltage across the capacitor is plus 5 volts and the input voltage is plus 5 volts. So that a total of output voltage 10 volts is going to be appearing across the output. So my output is going to be plus 10 volts. Okay. So again, when I apply my negative input voltage, okay, again when I apply my negative input voltage, what happens now? whenever I apply my negative input voltage, my diode is going to be on. When my diode is going to be on, okay, my output is going to be zero. Okay, so whenever I apply my positive 5 volts, okay, my diode is going to be off. Okay, so that my output is given by voltage across the capacitor plus input voltage, so that it is going to be plus 10. Okay, so likewise, we can complete the cycle, and this is what is the output you can observe. Okay, so initially, okay, so initially, as long as my capacitor is not charging, or as long as my capacitor voltage is zero, my output is same as the input. Okay, so initially my output is same as input, but after once my capacitor has got accumulated with some value, then my output voltage is given by Vi plus Vm. Okay, for example, my Vm is plus 5 volts. When I add to my Vi, that is minus 5, to the plus 5 volts, then it is given by 0 volts. Okay, so this is plus 5 volts. When I add to plus 5 volts, it is plus 10 volts. Minus 5 volts, when I add to the Vm, that is plus 5 volts, minus 5 plus 5 is 0 volts. Okay, so by adding to your input plus Vm, you will be getting your output. Or in other words, your negative peak, as this is a positive clamper, your negative peak is being clamped to 0. Negative peak is clamped to 0. Okay, so in a positive clamper, you can say that your negative peak is being clamped to the 0 if the positive clamper is an ideal positive clamper circuit. Okay, right. Analysis of negative clamper circuit using ideal diode model. Here is the circuit for a negative clamper circuit. Here we are taking the output across the diode such that my positive terminal of the output voltage is connected to the P side of the diode and negative terminal of the output is connected to the N side of the diode. Okay, here we would like to analyze this circuit assuming that the diode is ideal. Whenever a sinusoidal input signal is applied, which is shown like this. Okay, so we are considering a sinusoidal input signal which is starting at t is equal to 0. Okay, assume initially that the capacitor voltage is 0. Okay, so before the input is getting applied, let us assume that the capacitor is initially uncharged. With this assumption that my voltage across the capacitor is 0, my entire input voltage is going to appear across the diode. Okay, so over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is going to be forward biased. Why my diode is going to be forward biased? Because over the interval 0 to T by 4, over the interval 0 to T by 4, my input is positive. When a positive input is applied across the diode, it is going to be making my diode forward biased. So with diode forward biased, I'll be replacing my diode with a short circuit so that current is going to flow from P side to the N side. And I have chosen the voltage across the capacitor with the polarities as shown in accordance with the current direction of the diode, that is from P side to the N side. So as and when the diode is conducting, as and when the diode is in the forward bias, the current is going to flow through the capacitor and the capacitor is going to start charging. Okay. And the time constant that if you find out, it is going to be zero. As the time constant is negligible, almost zero, the voltage across the capacitor is going to be quickly reaching the input voltage that is being applied. And what is my voltage across the capacitor is given by? Same as the input voltage. So when I apply the KVL around this particular loop, we will be able to get VC as same as VI. So in particular, at T is equal to capital T by 4, when I try to find my voltage across the capacitor, it is given by same as the input voltage. At that time instant T by 4, my input is Vm. So my voltage across the capacitor is also going to be Vm. Right? So when I am considering this interval 0 to T by 4, that means T by 4 minus my voltage across the capacitor is Vm. It will be same even at T by 4 plus, because my voltage across the capacitor cannot change instantaneously. Vc of T by 4 minus is equal to Vc of T by 4 plus, which is nothing but given by Vm. Okay, so over this interval, my output is going to be 0 because my diode is being replaced with short circuit, output voltage is 0. So let me draw the output voltage first. Let us consider the next interval, that is over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2. Over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, okay, my voltage across the capacitor is not 0, but it is Vm. Because in the earlier cycle 0 to T by 4, my diode is on, thereby my capacitor has started charging, and it has reached, by the time I reach T by 4, a value of Vm, okay. So if you want to know whether the diode is in the forward bias or in the reverse bias, okay, you need to find the voltage across the diode with the polarity shown here and represented as Vd. If my Vd is positive, I say that diode is forward bias. If my Vd is negative, I say that diode is reverse bias. Okay. So let me write an equation for my Vd. So Vd is equal to, which is the taken polarities, minus Vc plus Vi. But Vc, you know that it is Vm. So upon replacing Vc with Vm, my Vd is being given by minus Vm plus Vi. Okay. Let Vm is equal to 10 volts. Okay. Then what happens? My Vi over this interval T by 4 to T by 2, my Vi at T by 4, it is plus 10 volts. With the assumption that my Vm is 10 volts, at T by 4, it is plus 10 volts. T by 4 plus means after T by 4, your input is getting reduced. Okay, from the 10 value of 10. So that is 9.9, 9.8, 9.7 and so on. So when I substitute randomly some values for my input voltage over this interval, I'll be getting my Vd to be negative. Okay. So when my Vd is found to be negative, my diode is said to be in the reverse bias. Okay. For my diode to be in the forward bias, my Vd has to be positive. For what value of Vi, my Vd can be positive? For my Vd to be positive, my Vi has to go beyond 10 volts. Okay, that means more than 10 volts, if my Vi can be, then only my Vd is going to be positive, then only my diode is going to be forward biased. But can my input go beyond 10 volts if my peak value is chosen to be 10 volts? No, it cannot. So as it is impossible for my input to go beyond plus 10 volts, my Vd can never be positive. Thereby, my diode can never be in the on state. So, not only over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, from T by 4 to up to infinity, my diode will still be in the off state only, that is in the reverse biased region only. Okay. So, with my diode reverse biased, I replaced my diode with open circuit, and when I look at my charging, okay, discharging time constant, it is RLC. And as I am choosing my RLC as much greater than capital T, which is my time period of the input signal, which is the requirement for the proper operation of the clamping circuit, thereby my capacitor is not able to discharge through this available path through the RL, because my discharging time constant RLC is very, very large. So as my capacitor is not able to discharge through the available path, it is able to hold the value which it has got accumulated during the earlier cycle when the diode is switched off. Okay, so the voltage across the capacitor is now a value which is Vn, okay, with the polarity shown here, right? So that my voltage across the capacitor with the value of Vm, okay, my output voltage is now being given by Vi minus Vm, okay? So my output voltage is now being given by Vi minus Vm, okay? So my output simply follows the equation Vi minus Vm. So when I use this equation for plotting the output voltage, I may get like this. Okay, so this is what is my output voltage, how it looks like. So you could see that at any instant of time, my output is being given by Vi minus Vm. Okay, but of course, before it has reached the steady state, this equation may not be valid. Okay, so that is over the interval 0 to T by 4, my output is 0 because my diode is conducting, thereby my output is 0. And my capacitor has started charging to reach up to Vm, okay. When once my capacitor has got reached to its maximum value, and whenever the diode is getting into the off state, so that my diode will never get into the on state, so that my capacitor is going to be holding that value as it cannot discharge, as the discharging time constant is very large, then the clamping operation comes into the picture, okay. So you could see from T by 4 onwards, you could see that your output is being given by Vi minus Vm. For example, when your Vi is minus Vm, Vi minus Vm is nothing but minus 2 Vm. Okay. So when your input is plus Vm, your output is likely to be 0. Okay. So your output is simply following Vi minus Vm, and more or less, your positive peak has got clamped to 0 volts. Okay. So unlike in your positive clamper circuit where negative peak has got clamped to 0, in the negative clamper circuit, positive peak has got clamped to 0. Okay. So that is one differentiation what we could make from the positive clamper circuit and the negative clamper circuit. Okay. So let us consider the input waveform, which is exactly similar to the input waveform that we considered earlier, but this time the circuit is a negative clamper circuit. So when I apply the positive half cycle, that is plus 5 volts, to my circuit, assuming that my voltage across the capacitor is initially 0, my entire 5 volts is going to appear across the diode, which will make my diode on, so that my output is going to be 0 with a time constant which is 0. Okay, so that my entire input voltage is going to be appearing across the capacitor. Okay, so my output voltage is going to be 0 for the first positive half cycle where my input is plus 5 volts. When a negative half cycle, that is minus 5 volts, is applied to the circuit, okay, so in the earlier cycle, my capacitor has got charged to up to 5 volts. So now with plus 5 volts across the capacitor and applied minus 5 volts as an input, my voltage across the diode is being given by minus 5 and minus 5. Okay, that is minus 10 volts, right? So as minus 10 volts is applied across the diode, which makes the diode off. But as the discharging time constant is very, very large compared to the capital T, my capacitor is not able to discharge. Instead, it is able to hold that value, that is 5 volts. Okay, so that my output voltage is being given by minus 5, minus 5, that is minus 10 volts. Okay, right. Again, when my 5 volts is being applied, again my diode is in the on state, my output is going to be in the 0. Okay, when my minus 5 volts is being applied, my output is given by voltage across the capacitor plus the input, that is minus 10 volts. So this is how the cycle is going to repeat. Okay. So this is the output waveform of the negative clamper circuit. Okay, this is the output waveform of the negative clamper circuit, where your output is following Vi minus Vm, or you could see that your positive peak has got clamped to 0 volts. Okay, so this is my positive peak, it has got clamped to 0 volts. Positive peak clamped to 0, positive peak clamped to 0, positive peak clamped to 0, positive peak clamped to 0. Okay, following the output equation, you will be getting this waveform. Or in other words, by following the same thing, you could observe that positive peak has got clamped to the 0 volts. Okay, alright. Analysis of positive clamper circuit using diode equivalent resistance model. Okay. So again, the same positive clamper circuit we have considered, but this time we will be replacing our diode with its equivalent resistance. So that is, whenever the diode is said to be forward biased, we will be replacing it with a forward biased resistance, capital R suffix small f. Whenever the diode is said to be in the reverse biased, we will be replacing it with a large reverse resistance, that is capital R suffix small r. Okay, so that is what is we are likely to do in the analysis of the same positive clamper circuit. Okay, right. So the same input signal we have considered. Okay, so initially we will assume that capacitor is uncharged, so voltage across the capacitor is 0 initially before we apply the input signal, with the assumption that my voltage across the capacitor is 0. Okay, my entire input voltage is going to appear across the diode. Okay, so over the interval 0 to T by 4, diode is in the reverse bias. Okay, earlier we used to replace my diode with an open circuit, but this time we will be replacing my diode with a large reverse resistance. Okay, so when I try to find the time constant, okay, so my time constant is being given by RTH into C, where RTH is the equivalent resistance, that is this large reverse resistance capital R suffix small r in parallel with RL. Okay, as this large reverse resistance is very larger in magnitude, okay, ideally it is infinity, In practice, it is very large. So my equivalent resistance of parallel combination of these two resistances will be RL. Okay. So my time constant is RL into C. As I'll be choosing my RL into C is much greater than capital T, my time period of the input signal. Okay. So my voltage across the capacitor is still going to be zero even up to capital T by 4. So that is why at T by 4 minus my voltage across the capacitor is zero. So thereby my voltage across the capacitor at T by 4 plus is also same. Okay. So over this interval 0 to T by 4, my output is same as the input. Okay. So here, why my output is same as the input? Because my voltage across the capacitor is 0. So my output is same as the input. Let me draw the output which is following the input over the interval 0 to T by 4. Okay. Let us consider the next interval, that is T by 4 to capital T by 2. Over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, okay, still my voltage across the capacitor is 0. Okay. So with my voltage across the capacitor 0, I'll assume that my entire input voltage is appearing across the diode. Okay. And over this interval, my input is still positive, which will be making my diode reverse biased. Thereby, I'll be replacing my diode with large reverse resistance. Okay. Right. And my time constant is given by RLC, which is much greater than capital T, which will make my voltage across the capacitor is still zero towards the end of this interval also. That is, my VC of T at T is equal to capital T by 2 is still zero. Okay. And my output voltage over this interval is still following the input as my voltage across the capacitor is zero. Let us continue with the next interval, that is T by 2 to 3T by 4. Okay. Over this interval, my voltage across the capacitor is 0. So that means my entire input voltage is appearing across the diode. But this time, over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, okay, over this interval, my input is negative. When my input is negative, that is applied across this diode, which is positioned from N to P, then my diode is going to be forward biased. Okay. My diode is going to be forward biased. Thereby, I'll be replacing my diode with a small forward biased resistance. Earlier, I used to replace my diode with a short circuit. But this time, I would like to replace my diode with a forward biased resistance. Thereby, my current is flowing from P side to the N side. And I am representing my voltage across the capacitor with the polarities as shown in accordance with the current flowing through the diode. Okay. So when I find the time constant, it is being given as RFC. Okay. So the equivalent resistance of RF in parallel with RL is RF, as RF is very small compared to RL. My time constant is going to be RFC. So upon assumption that RF is also very small, okay, my voltage across the capacitor is being given by, okay, minus VC. Okay, so my voltage across the capacitor is being given by minus VC. So when I apply the KVL around this loop, I'll be getting that my VC is equal to minus VI. Okay, right? My voltage across the capacitor at T is equal to 3T by 4. It is being given by VM. Why VM? Because at 3T by 4, my input is minus VM and my voltage across the capacitor is minus VI. So minus of minus, that is plus Vm, okay. And my output is approximated to be zero. As my time constant is negligible, my entire input voltage will be appearing across the capacitor. Thereby, my output voltage is very small or negligible, okay. So I have shown here almost zero, right. So let me plot that output waveform over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, which it is being shown as zero. Let us consider the next interval, that is 3T by 4 to capital T. Over this interval, my voltage across the capacitor is Vm, just now we have seen. Okay. So if you want to know whether your diode is in the forward bias region or reverse bias region, okay, you need to find out the voltage across the diode with the polarities shown here. With the polarities shown here, if my voltage across the diode Vd is positive, my diode is said to be in the reverse bias. If VD is negative, then my diode is said to be in the forward bias. Okay, so let me write an equation for my VD. My V naught, and which is equal to your VD, it can be written as VC plus VI. But VC, you know, which is VM. Okay, let VM is equal to 10 volts. Okay, so with VM 10 volts, and what is your VI is in between 3T by 4 to capital T, in between 3T by 4, that is from this point of time to this point of time, at exactly T is equal to 3T by 4, it is minus the 10 volts. As I am moving from 3T by 4 to capital T, my input is going to be like minus 9.9, minus 9.8 and so on. So when I replace some values of my input like minus 9.9, minus 9.8 and so on, my VD is going to be positive. Whenever my VD is positive, which is the polarity shown across the diode here, my diode is said to be in the reverse bias. Okay. And for my diode to be forward biased, my VD has to be negative. For what value of VI, your VD is going to be negative? My VI is going to be, my VI has to be beyond minus 10 volts, so that my VD is going to be negative. Okay. Only when my VD is negative, then only my diode is going to be in the forward bias. But for my VD to be negative, my VI has to go beyond minus 10 volts. But is it possible for the input to go beyond minus 10 volts if my peak value is given as minus 10 volts? No. So as my input voltage cannot go beyond minus 10 volts, my VD cannot be negative, so that my output, so that my voltage across the diode is always positive, which will make my diode reverse biased. Okay. So with the diode reverse biased, okay, I'll be replacing my diode with large reverse resistance, so that my time constant is given by RLC. As RLC is very large compared to capital T, my capacitor cannot be able to discharge through the RL, and my capacitor is likely to hold the value that it has got accumulated during the earlier cycle. Okay, so with the accumulation of voltage across the capacitor, my output voltage is being given by VI plus VM. Okay, my output voltage is given by VI plus VM. Okay, right. So my output voltage is simply following the equation VI plus VM. So when I use this equation, I'll be getting my output voltage, okay, which is shown here. This is how my output voltage is going to look like. Okay, so over the interval 0 to T by 2, okay, my output is same as the input, and over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, my output is 0, and from 3T by 4 onwards, even up to infinity, my diode is going to be in the off state, that is in the reverse bias. Then my capacitor is likely to hold the value that it has got accumulated during the earlier cycle, and my output voltage is always being given by VI plus VM. Okay, so that is why even when you look at your VM, is input is VM at this instant of time, your output is 2 VM. Okay, when my input is minus VM, so minus VM plus VM, that is 0. Okay, so your negative peaks are getting clamped to the 0. Okay, positive clamper circuit means negative peak is clamped to the 0. Okay, right. Analysis of negative clamper circuit using diode equivalent resistance model. Okay, negative clamper circuit. So here is the negative clamper circuit, okay, what we have seen earlier, but this time we will be using the diode equivalent resistance model. So that is, we will be replacing diode with its forward biased small resistance when it is being operated in the forward bias region, and we will replace the diode with large reverse resistance when it is being operated in the reverse bias region. Okay, and we will try to analyze this circuit when the input signal is a sinusoidal signal, that is being shown here. Okay, so let us assume that the input is starting at T is equal to 0, right? Assume that initially the capacitor is 0, that is the voltage across the capacitor is 0. Okay, so that means capacitor is initially uncharged. So with the assumption that capacitor is initially uncharged, okay, that my entire input voltage is going to appear across the diode, right? So over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is being forward biased. Okay. As a positive voltage is appearing across the diode, which is shown here, my diode is said to be in the forward biased region. Thereby, I replaced my diode with the small forward biased resistance, that is RF. Okay. So when I try to find the time constant, it is given by RFC. Okay, the time constant is given by RFC, which is very small, so that my entire input voltage will be accumulated across the capacitor. Okay, so as my diode is conducting, my capacitor is going to start charging, okay, with the polarities that are being shown here in accordance with the current direction through the diode, that is from P side to the N side. Okay. So my voltage across the capacitor is being given by same as the input voltage. So in particular, my voltage at T is equal to T by 4, it is being given as plus Vm. Because at T is equal to T by 4, my input voltage is plus Vm. So my voltage across the capacitor is same as the input voltage. So my voltage across the capacitor at T by 4 minus and plus is same as Vm. Okay. And over this interval 0 to T by 4, my output voltage is very close to 0. Okay, so though it is not exactly 0, as I have replaced my diode with a small forward bias resistance, but nevertheless, as the time constant is very small, my voltage across the capacitor is going to be almost equivalent to the input, thereby my output is very close to the 0. So let me draw the output waveform over that interval 0 to T by 4. Okay, so now let us consider the another interval, that is from T by 4 to T by 2. Over the interval T by 4 to T by 2, my voltage across the capacitor is not being 0 now, it is instead plus Vm. Okay. So if you want to know whether your diode is in the forward biased or reverse biased, you need to find out whether your Vd, voltage across the diode, which is shown with the polarities here, is positive, then the diode is said to be in the forward biased. If Vd is negative, then the diode is said to be in the reverse biased. Okay. So let me write an equation for my Vd. Okay. So that I can write it as minus Vc plus Vi. But Vc is nothing but Vm. So replacing Vc with Vm, okay, I can say that my Vd is equal to minus Vm plus Vi. Okay. So let Vm is equal to some 10 volts. Okay. Then what is that I can write? In the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, okay, my input is going to be, when I look at my T by 4 to capital T by 2, my input is going to be at T by 4, it is plus 10 with the assumption that Vm is 10 volts. At T by 4 plus, my input is going to be 9.9, 9.8, much less than the 10 volts. Okay, so with all those values of Vi representation, I can find that my Vd is going to be negative. With the polarity shown, okay, my Vd is negative means my diode is said to be in the reverse bias. Okay. So for my diode to be in the forward biased, my Vd has to be positive. For my Vd to be positive, what should be my Vi has to be? My Vi has to go beyond 10 volts. Only then my Vd is going to be positive. Only then my diode is going to be in the forward biased region. But can my Vi go beyond plus 10 volts? No. As my Vi can go up to a maximum of plus 10 volts, as it is not possible for Vi to go beyond plus 10 volts. Okay. So my Vd going to become positive can never happen. Thereby my diode is always being in the reverse bias region. Okay. So with the diode reverse biased, okay, I have replaced my diode with a large reverse resistance and my time constant is given by RLC. Okay. That is the discharging time constant, as it is very large compared to capital T. Okay. My capacitor cannot be able to discharge through the available path, that is RL. Okay, but instead it is able to hold that value which it has got accumulated during the earlier cycle. Okay, so with the accumulation of some voltage across the capacitor, my output voltage is being given by Vi minus Vm. Okay, so my output voltage is going to follow Vi minus Vm. So when I use this equation, I'll be getting my output voltage as shown here. Okay, so this is how my output voltage is going to look like, right? So over the interval 0 to T by 4, right, my output is 0 because my diode is conducting. Whenever my diode is conducting, my capacitor starts charging and it reaches to the maximum value by the time it reaches this T by 4. And beyond this T by 4, my diode is going to be in the off state. Okay. As my diode is going to be in the off state, my capacitor cannot be able to discharge through RL as my discharging time constant is very large. Intentionally it is made so that my output voltage is going to follow Vi minus Vm. Okay. So you could see that when my Vi is minus Vm, my output is minus 2 Vm. When my Vi is plus Vm, my output is 0. So, or in other words, positive peak has got clamped to the 0. That is what is the negative clamping circuit is. Okay. So, in a positive clamper circuit, negative peak has got clamped to 0. In a negative clamper circuit, positive peak has clamped to the 0. Okay. Right. Analysis of positive clamper circuit using constant voltage drop model. Okay. Let us again consider a positive clamper circuit, but this time let us use the constant voltage drop model. Okay, the same input signal, that is sinusoidal input signal, is considered now also, but the model that we will be using for the analysis of this circuit is constant voltage drop model. Okay, assume initially that the voltage across the capacitor is zero. With the voltage across the capacitor is zero, the entire input voltage is going to appear across the branch that is in shunt with the RL. Okay. So more or less I had replaced my diode with its constant voltage drop model. Now this particular diode is going to be an ideal diode as the voltage drop of the diode has got included here. Okay. So over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is reverse biased. So thereby my diode has been replaced with an open circuit, because upon replacing my diode with its constant voltage drop model, diode is no more going to be a practical diode, it is an ideal diode. Okay. So when once my diode is reverse biased, the diode is replaced with an open circuit. Okay. And when I try to find the time constant, the time constant is found to be RLC, as RLC is very large compared to capital T, the time period of the input signal. My voltage across the capacitor is going to be zero. Okay, right? And my output is being given as same as input, because my voltage across the capacitor is zero. So let me draw the output waveform over this interval 0 to T by 4, right? Let us consider the next interval, that is T by 4 to capital T by 2. Over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, my voltage across the capacitor is still zero. That means my entire input voltage is going to appear across the branch parallel to the RL. Okay. So over this interval T by 4 to T by 2, still my input voltage is positive, so which will make my diode forward reverse biased. With my diode reverse biased, I will be replacing my diode with open circuit, so that my time constant is being given by RLC. As RLC is always made much larger than capital T, my voltage across the capacitor is still going to be zero. Okay. And my output voltage over the interval T by 4 to T by 2 is still going to be same as the input voltage. Okay. As long as my voltage across the capacitor is zero, my output voltage is same as the input. Okay. Now let us consider the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4. Over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, my voltage across the capacitor is 0. With the voltage across the capacitor is 0, my entire input voltage is going to appear across the branch parallel to the RL. Okay. But this time, my input is going to be negative. Okay. Over T by 2 to 3T by 4, my input is negative. Okay. So that means my diode is going to be forward biased, for my Vi is greater than minus V gamma. Okay. So as long as my P side of the diode is more than my N side of the diode, my diode is said to be in the forward biased. Okay. So my diode is going to be in the forward biased, for my Vi, which is tied to the N side of my diode, should be greater than my minus V gamma, which is tied to the P side of my diode. Okay. If I find what is my time constant is, my time constant is being given by 0, so that my voltage across the capacitor is charging almost towards equal to the input voltage that is applied. Okay. So whenever my diode is in the on state, it is going to conduct from P side to the N side, and I have chosen the voltage across the capacitor with the polarity as shown here, which is in accordance with the current through the diode, that is from P side to the N side. That means whenever the diode is conducting, my capacitor starts charging. Okay, so and what is the value of the capacitor is given as, it is plus Vc plus Vi plus V gamma, okay, is equal to 0. Just applying KVL around this loop, I'll be getting that plus Vc is equal to minus of Vi plus V gamma. In particular at t is equal to 3t by 4, my Vc is given as, okay, at 3t by 4 my input is minus Vm. When I replace my Vi with minus Vm, okay, it is Vm minus V gamma. So voltage across the capacitor at 3t by 4 is given by Vm minus V gamma, okay. And over the same interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, my output is given by, because my diode is being replaced with short circuit, my output is given by minus V gamma. Okay. Let me draw the output waveform as minus V gamma. So now let us move on to the next interval, that is 3T by 4 to capital T. Over the interval 3T by 4 to capital T, my voltage across the capacitor is Vm minus V gamma. Okay. And now if you want to know whether your diode is in the forward biased or reverse biased, okay, with the polarity of the voltage across the diode that is shown here, if Vd is positive, my diode is going to be reverse biased. If Vd is negative, my diode is going to be forward biased. Okay, so let me write an equation for my Vd by writing KVL. Okay, so Vc plus Vi plus V gamma minus Vd is equal to 0. From which I can write Vd is equal to Vc plus V gamma plus Vi. But you know that Vc is equal to V gamma minus V gamma. Sorry, Vc is equal to Vm minus V gamma. So when I replace my Vc is equal to Vm minus V gamma, okay. So this V gamma gets cancelled. My Vd is given by Vm plus Vi. Okay. So let Vm is equal to 10 volts. When I replace my Vm is equal to 10 volts, over this interval 3t by 4 to capital T, my input is, it has to be at 3t by 4 it is minus 10 volts, at 3t by 4 plus it has to be less than minus, greater than minus 10 volts, that is minus 9.9, minus 9.8 and so on, which will be making my Vd always positive. Okay, so with Vd positive, my diode is going to be in the reverse biased. For my diode to be in the forward biased, my Vd has to be negative. For my Vd to be negative, my Vi has to go beyond minus 10. That is minus 10.01, 10.1 and so on. But can my input can go beyond minus 10 volts? No. So as my input going beyond minus 10 volts is not possible, my Vd will always be positive, which will be making my diode always off, not only up to the interval up to capital T, but even from 3T by 4 to up to infinity, my diode is always in the off state. Okay, that is in the reverse bias region. With the diode in the reverse bias region, okay, I'll replace my diode with an open circuit, and when I try to find my time constant, it is RLC. As RLC is very large compared to the capital T, my voltage across the capacitor is going to remain as it is, because it cannot discharge through the RL, as discharging time constant is very large compared to the capital T. Okay, so that my output voltage is given by Vc plus Vi, where Vc is nothing but Vm minus V gamma plus Vi. Okay, so my output voltage will be following this particular equation. So when I use this equation, my output voltage is going to look like this. Okay, so until my 0 to T by 2, my output is same as the input, and over the interval T by 2 to 3T by 4, where your diode is conducting, because your diode drop is being taken into the consideration, my output voltage is going to be at minus 0.7. And beyond 3T by 4, your diode is going to be in the off state, and as your voltage across, as your capacitor cannot be able to discharge, it is going to hold the value that it has got accumulated during the earlier cycle. My output voltage follows Vm minus V gamma plus Vi. Okay, right. And also you could see that when I am taking my forward voltage drop of the diode into account, okay, you could see that earlier for an ideal diode, your negative peak has got clamped to the zero, but now your negative peak has got clamped to the minus 0.7. Okay, minus 0.7. Okay, right. Analysis of negative clamper circuit using constant voltage drop model. Let us consider the negative clamper circuit. Analysis of negative clamper circuit using constant voltage drop model. Let us consider the negative clamper circuit. The circuit is shown here. The input signal which is being applied to the circuit is also shown here. Only thing is that we need to use a constant voltage drop model. Let us assume that the capacitor is initially uncharged. With that assumption, my entire input voltage is going to appear across the branch that is parallel to the RL, and I have replaced my diode with a constant voltage drop model, so that this particular diode is now going to be an ideal diode. Okay, over the interval 0 to T by 4, my diode is being forward biased for my VI is greater than V gamma. Okay, so as and when my diode is forward biased, I replaced my diode with a short circuit, so that my time constant is being given as 0, so that my entire input voltage will be appearing across the capacitor. Okay, my voltage across the capacitor is given as, when I apply the KVL across this loop, minus VC plus VI minus V gamma is equal to 0, so that VC is equal to VI minus V gamma. Okay, so at T is equal to T by 4, okay, my voltage across the capacitor is given as VI at T by 4, it is VM, okay, so my voltage across the capacitor is given by VM minus V gamma. Okay, over this interval 0 to T by 4, okay, my output voltage is given by plus V gamma. Okay, so I have shown here with a green curve that my output voltage is being located at, let us say, roughly 0.7 volts. Okay, now let us consider the next interval, that is T by 4 to capital T by 2. Over the interval T by 4 to capital T by 2, my capacitor voltage is given by Vm minus V gamma. Okay, so when my voltage across the capacitor is given as Vm minus V gamma, if you want to know whether your diode is in the forward biased or reverse biased, okay, with the polarity of the voltage across the diode shown here, if Vd is positive, diode is said to be forward biased. If Vd is negative, diode is said to be reverse biased. If you want to know the state of the diode, you need to write an equation for the voltage across the diode. Okay, so let me write a KVL for this particular loop. So that is minus Vc plus Vi minus V gamma minus Vd is equal to 0. So that Vd is equal to minus Vc minus V gamma plus Vi, but you know that Vc is equal to Vm minus V gamma. So upon replacing Vc is equal to Vm minus V gamma, I can write minus Vm plus V gamma minus V gamma plus Vi, so that my Vd is being given as minus Vm plus Vi. So let Vm is equal to some 10 volts, let us say. Then I can write like, over this interval T by 4 to T by 2, okay, so at T by 4 it is plus 10 volts, at T by 4 plus it is 9.9, 9.8, less than 10. So when I roughly substitute some values of my Vi, my Vd is going to be negative. Okay, so with the polarity, that is voltage across the diode shown here, if it is negative, when Vd is negative, diode is said to be reverse biased. When Vd is positive, diode is said to be forward biased. So my Vd is going to be negative, making my diode reverse biased. For my diode to be forward biased, Vd has to be positive. For my Vd to be positive, what should be my Vi is? My Vi has to go beyond 10 volts. In order to make my Vd positive, my Vi has to be more than 10 volts, less 10 volts. but it is not possible for my VI to go beyond 10 volts. So it is not possible for my VD to become positive. Thereby, my diode will always be in the off state, not only up to the interval T by 2, but even beyond T by 2, that is up to infinity. That is from T by 4 to infinity, your diode will be in the off state only. So when my diode is in the reverse biased, I will be replacing that with an open circuit. And when I find my time constant, that is RLC, which is very large compared to the capital T, okay, thereby my capacitor cannot be able to discharge through the RL because my discharging time constant is very large compared to capital T. My capacitor is going to hold the value, which is the capacitor holding the value which is accumulated earlier. My output voltage is given by minus VC plus VI, okay, or VI minus VC, where I can replace my VC with whatever the value we got earlier. So that my output voltage is now given as VI minus VM plus V gamma. Okay, my output voltage is given as VI minus VM plus V gamma. So when I follow this particular output input equation, okay, my output voltage can be obtained as shown here. So this is how my output voltage is going to look like. So over the interval 0 to T by 4, okay, where my diode is being in the on state, my output voltage is being given by plus V gamma, that is roughly at 0.7 volts. But from beyond T by 4 to infinity, my diode is no more in the on state, it is going to be in the off state. When the diode is in the on state, the capacitor has got charged to the maximum value. And when the diode is in the off state, the capacitor cannot be able to discharge due to the large discharging time constant. So the capacitor is going to hold the value. As the capacitor is holding the value, the output voltage is given by VI minus VM plus V gamma. Okay. So for example, at this particular instant of time where your VM is, VI is minus VM, then your output is given by minus VM is minus 2 VM plus V gamma. Okay. So from here to here, it is minus 2 VM plus V gamma. Okay. In the earlier negative clamper circuit, we looked at the positive peak is clamped to the zero. Now your positive peak is clamped to the 0.7 volts. Okay. As you have considering your diode drop into account, earlier it has been clamped to 0, but this time it is being clamped to the 0.7 volts because the diode drop is taken into the consideration. Okay. So thank you all for your patience listening. I hope you have understood what we discussed so far. Thank you very much. See you next time.